Let's start with some of the bigger teams from yesterday. You let me know who impressed you the most. The Chiefs look like they bounced back, but they got a lot of issues. The Rams, I hate to say it, against your Giants, the Rams look very good. The Cardinals look very good. And Dallas went into New England and had an impressive win. Which team stuck out the most to you from yesterday?
Let me just say this in regards to the Giants. I'm not even mad at the Giants for getting they boot smoked the way they did, because the Rams, you know, could possibly be the best team in the NFC right now. And I don't want to disrespect the Cardinals, because I know they did beat the Rams to stop their undefeated streak. But, you know, I still got to give them a chance, because coming off of an energy-filled big matchup with the Buccaneers and winning that one, sometimes you can go out in a tough division game the following week and things don't go your way. So they do play each other another time this season. So I'll kind of, you know, debate and I'll make my conclusion after they play the second time versus each other. But if you want to talk about who impressed me this week, and I almost, when you asked me that question, I almost got excited and said, you know what, I need to go get up and switch my hat, because it's definitely my Baltimore Ravens, man. Lamar Jackson and those guys, you know, going into that game, they were considered the underdog against the Chargers. I thought the game would be a hell of a lot closer than what we saw, but they jumped out the gate to an early 14-0 lead, and at that point, I knew it was over with. That, like, there was no doubt in my mind that the Ravens were going to win that game from that point on. You know, I was talking about this with my dad, and I said, you know, it's so crazy how these guys literally went through every running back on the roster to start the season off, picked up three guys who have all had, you know, solid careers. Le'Veon Bell, Latavius Murray, and Devonta Freeman have had pretty solid careers, but to just kind of throw these guys into the flame, and, you know, they only you know, missed the record for most consecutive 100-yard rushing games by one game. They tied the record. Obviously, this past week, they didn't get – excuse me, last week, they didn't get it. But, you know, Lamar Jackson had his virtuoso of a performance, his career performance, you know, in that game last week. But to come back this week and to see what the running game continues to do, now they have the rookie Rashad Bateman. He's back in the lineup. I'm liking this team a lot. I'm still got my fingers crossed that maybe we can bring in Michael Thomas or something, because I'm hearing that they may want to work out some type of trade. You know, so if that is the case, I still would like Baltimore to put their hat in the ring on that one, because I mean, we're talking about Michael Thomas, who healthy is arguably top three wide receiver in football, you know. You might even want to push him closer to number one. I mean, he's had the receptions that he's had the past 3-4 years, the yardage, the touchdowns. You know, you could put him at number one easily if you wanted to. I wouldn't argue with you if you did. So I would still like to see that. But you know, I was very impressed by Baltimore and what they've been able to accomplish. 5-1. They could even be 6-0 right now. You know, going back to that week one loss to Oakland. I mean, excuse me, to Las Vegas, to the Raiders.
Old habits die hard.
Yeah.
Old habits die hard.
They could easily be 6-0 right now. So, you know, starting this season off. So they've impressed me probably the most. I was actually very happy for Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs for bouncing back, because I still think they're a really good team. I just think that they got a couple of chinks in their armor that need to be fixed. But I do still think Patrick Mahomes is the best quarterback in football right now.
Oh, without a doubt, Patrick Mahomes is the best quarterback. I just think that the Chiefs are playing very sloppy right now, which is a little shocking when you consider, one, they're a veteran-laden team, right? These guys have been together for quite some time. They've been to the mountaintop, so you would expect them to be a little more focused. Also, veteran coaching staff as well, so you wouldn't expect to see the mistakes that we see. They consistently put the ball on the ground, whether it's fumbles or receivers just having it bounce off their hands and go for interceptions. It happened again yesterday to Tyreek Hill. Mecole Hardman had a bad fumble. They got a lot of work to do. With all that being said, for as sloppy as they played, they still put up 31 points, and they probably could have put up 40 yesterday. So Mahomes, without a doubt, is the best quarterback. But I will say Lamar Jackson is playing the best football of his career. You and I challenged him a few weeks ago, and not him in particular. We challenged the receivers. Yeah. He said the receivers had to be better so that we could see the best version of Lamar. I think that's what we've seen since then. You know, yesterday to me was the most complete game the Ravens have played this year. I also thought yesterday's game was going to be close because the Chargers have been playing so well. And even though Lamar and the offense have been playing well, that Ravens defense had struggled. Last week, as you mentioned, the Colts moved the ball up and down the field on them. It happened, obviously, in the Kansas City game. It happened to them in the Detroit game. So they had a lot of games where they struggled defensively, but yesterday they put it together. The defense came together. The defense harassed Justin Herbert all game. That was the most complete game we've seen from Baltimore all year. And to highlight your point as well, all three of those new backs that were not there in preseason all scored a touchdown yesterday. Mm-hmm. So everyone got involved, along with Mark Andrews and Hollywood Brown in the passing game. So Baltimore is clicking on all cylinders. I truly think the sky's the limit for this team. It'll be interesting to see if Buffalo can win tonight to kind of keep pace, because both those teams lost opening night and have been trending in the right direction ever since then. But when you look at the AFC, the West is going to be a dogfight all the way to the end. The Chargers just lost. Baltimore impressively has a win over Kansas City and Chargers, who are the two teams vying for West. The South is a little iffy. The Colts look like they're getting themselves together. Tennessee's got a lot to prove. But right now, the number one seed is going to either be Baltimore or Buffalo.
Yeah.
And I think it's highly important for both those teams because of their young quarterbacks, because of their lack of winning experience in the playoffs. Both those quarterbacks only have, you know, a handful of playoff victories. Lamar has one. Josh Allen has two. If you could make it where the path to go to the Super Bowl has to come through you, you make your road a little easier. And I think now we're starting to see those two teams separate themselves. Also in favor of Baltimore, the Browns, who not only took a tough loss yesterday to Arizona, but now the injuries are starting to pile up. They didn't have Nick Chubb yesterday. They just got Odell Beckham back 2 weeks ago. They didn't have Nick Chubb yesterday. They lose Kareem Hunt for a few weeks now. Baker Mayfield has hurt his shoulder for the second time in 4 weeks. It was in a sling. They said it was a separation, but he still played the rest of the game. They got to turn around on a short week right now. This division could get away from everyone really quickly if Baltimore keeps playing this way. Baltimore could possibly wrap up this division by early December.
Yeah. I mean, you know, I'm happy about that. I will have no complaints whatsoever. But yeah, you know, it's tough losses for the Cleveland Browns, and that's the other reason why I'm so impressed with Baltimore and what they've been able to accomplish this season, because they started this season with 12 starters on the injured list. The three running backs won't be back for the season. They've been able to plug in those holes and fill things out. Marcus Peters, who's one of the top cornerbacks in this league, and which is a big part of the Ravens secondary being the best secondary in football right now, he was gone for the start of the season. Jimmy Smith was gone to start the season. So that secondary was depleted. But the fact that they've been able to overcome all of those injuries and to start this season off 5-1, and this is not a situation where, you know, we always have those teams that they might start the season off 7-0, 6-0, but it, you know, those are water weight victories, you know what I mean? And then they come back down to earth. This is not that. This is a team that is a playoff team. They're on the cusp of being a Super Bowl team. But this could possibly be the year if they keep this up. Like you said, you know, right now I'm looking at them and I'm looking at Buffalo. And you said it, you know, I'm looking at Buffalo tonight too, see if they can maintain. You know, Tennessee is a very tough team to beat when they're healthy, and they, you know, Julio was back, AJ Brown is back. So this is going to be a tough Monday Night Football game for Buffalo. And I think this is a very important game for Buffalo because you want to keep pace, like you said, with the Ravens. The pressure is on right now because they've already played their game and won, and they've dominated too. That's the other thing in that game. So I'm looking not just to see Buffalo scrape out a win in this situation. Show me that you're the best team in the AFC against another top team, another playoff team in the AFC. Show me how well you play against this team. You know, Derrick Henry it's not an easy job to stop Derrick Henry. You know, it took a while for Baltimore to get over that hump, being Derrick Henry. They finally got past that in the playoffs this past season. I want to see what Buffalo does, but, you know, Buffalo is another complete team. Defense is clicking. Offense is looking really well. You know, so I'm looking at those two teams right now as well. And I do think in a couple of weeks, we're going to be back to talking about the Chiefs like we used to talking about them as well. And I think teams in the AFC.
Yeah, Chiefs aren't going anywhere. I just think that they're making it their road to potentially a third Super Bowl much tougher now, because it's no longer a foregone conclusion that they're going to win the division. Now they got to actually work on it to win the division. You got the Chargers at 4-2. You got the Raiders at 4-2. And we got to get into some John Gruden talk as well. But in terms of, like you said, Ravens and Buffalo, they're both completely in the driver's seat in their division with an opportunity to put it away very early. Because even though the Patriots have played well, they've had some tough losses. They're 2-4. The Dolphins are a complete mess. I mean, we can get into that London game yesterday. I don't know what's going on with the Dolphins at this point, but they're 1-5. And the Jets are 1-4 going into their – this was their bye week, and they come back next week. So Buffalo has an opportunity to put the division in a complete headlock if they just take care of business tonight. And that's a good point, too, that you made about against another playoff-caliber team. Buffalo's riding high. They feel like they kind of got the monkey off their back beating Kansas City last week. Don't have a letdown now on primetime football. Come right back, make a statement, and let the rest of the AFC know that, hey, we might be the best team in the AFC and everything's got to come through us. In terms of Baltimore, as you mentioned, kudos to them because their schedule hasn't been easy either. We got to give credit. The Raiders are 4-2, right? They had the game against Kansas City, game against the Chargers, and they played a feisty Colts team that over the last 3 weeks, the Colts have looked better. And obviously, they had to come back to be able to beat the Colts. If not, the Colts would be on a 3-game winning streak. So the Ravens, a lot of credit due to them. I want to just go through the next couple of games for the Ravens for you. I had to look it up because they could get a little fat on the schedule here. They got a pesky Bengals team, which I think that's going to be a good game. Bengals look good. But then after that, they get a Minnesota team that I think they should handle. They get the Dolphins that are a complete mess. They get that inexperienced Bears team. And then they get the Browns, who we don't know what they're going to look like at that point 4 weeks from now, again, with the injuries. Kareem Hunt probably won't be back. Nick Chubb should be back by then, but we don't know what's going on with Baker. Long story short, if you're the Ravens, if you handle your business and win 3 out of them 4 games, now you're sitting at 8-2 going into the home stretch to the end of the season.
Absolutely. And to be honest with you, those four games, there's a really good chance that the Ravens come out of that at 9-1, because I think they're better than Cincinnati. You know, division games are always tough, but they're better than Cincinnati, and I think they'll beat them. I mean, Miami, nothing going on right there. We just lost to the Jaguars